Welcome to the Relisha Blocks podcast. I am your host, Victoria Bond. Join me as we chat about mindset, consciousness, and turning up your potency so you can get clear on your divine mission here on earth. I'm a spiritual empowerment coach. I use intuition, mediumship, and life coaching with my clients so they can create the life they truly desire. I believe we are here to be wealthy and healthy. If you desire more of this in your life, then this is the podcast for you. My mission is to share my knowledge of entity clearing, shifting limiting beliefs, and becoming more conscious within our bodies and minds so we can fulfill our life's purpose. I will be bringing you weekly podcasts with interviews, solos, and pre-recorded juicy lives from my socials. Thank you for being here. I hope you enjoy the podcast, and if you do, I would love you to please follow me here and find me at Holistic Energy Shifting on Facebook, where you can find a heap of free inspiration and information to shift the energy and grow abundance. Now let's get into today's episode. Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Relisha Blocks podcast. Today we have a very special guest, who is Vanessa Howlick. Thank you for joining us today, Vanessa.
Thank you so much for inviting me. I'm so excited to be here.
I'm so excited that you are here. So cool. And I'm just going to introduce you for a moment so everybody who doesn't know you or those who do know you may learn something about you that they don't know. So Vanessa is a mindset and business coach. She's been featured in Forbes. That is super exciting. And what I love so much about her is she brings in a different approach. So she actually brings in Reiki and breathwork and human design and like a spirit kind of soul connection in with her coaching. But at the same time, she still gets the things done and gets massive results for her clients. So would that be kind of, do you want to add anything to that, Vanessa? That's the short story.
Yeah, so I think just maybe doing a little bit of backstory on it was I started my business very much from that masculine space of get the funnels done, create this, do that. And it was very much this hustle space. How many hours can you do in a day? And how many clients can you take on? And how exhausted basically can you feel? So I ended up burning out in 2018 and kind of getting to this space of very much feeling exhausted, actually really dreading my business and feeling totally out of alignment. So I started to heal and started to connect back to my truth, to spirit, to alignment, doing my human design, doing breathwork, doing Reiki. And what I realized was with myself of how I was able to shift into this new space of true alignment and true joy in my business. And that when you create that mind, spirit, soul, and energy connection in your business and actually use more intuitive marketing, it's a beautiful space to be. So adding in the human design and having that reading with my clients is such a powerful space to be in because we can actually see exactly what your purpose is, where you're meant to go in your business, and then creating from that has been such a beautiful. So I think it was kind of born out of me feeling like there must be a better way. There has to be some fun and joy. And obviously I loved what I did, but I just couldn't sustain the level of kind of launch and sell and create and do and the stress and anxiety that I had created for myself and knowing that wasn't how we were meant to be operating in our business, and then being able to see kind of how all those modalities work with clients and connecting them back. It's just been beautiful. It's been, yes, the money is obviously important and it's an incredible part, but how do you want to feel on a day-to-day basis? How happy are you in your business? How sustainable is your business? All kind of, yeah, the questions that I really, who am I? I suppose is one of the biggest questions. So yeah, it's just deeper. It's more incredible. It's more holistic. And it's working on all areas that really we can have it all. So that's where that came from. And then all my passions and I'm a manifesting generator in human design. So I just love all the things.
Yeah, and I find that's really interesting as well. There's a lot of like what you describe as hustle. Like, so when you started your business, obviously you're an entrepreneur, obviously you have a massive heart and, you know, the soul connection with your clients and desire to get their massive results like what you've done. And then when 2018 hit, when your exhaustion hit, basically it's like that hustle, you couldn't maintain it. So you had to do more aligning. So like, I've got this random question for you, and that is, wherever people think there has to be hustle to make money, where they have to work harder, which is something that you really, I know you'd coach on this, when they think that they have to work harder instead of doing what brings them joy, what would you say to those people? Because I can hear people right now going, yeah, that's great, Vanessa, because you made your money first and then you aligned. Like, you know, people try to find excuses. So when you're bringing that holistic into this, like, you are like a businesswoman, you are an entrepreneur, you know your stuff. I know you know your stuff because I follow you and I'm also a part of one of your programs. So I'm looking at your stuff going, this lady knows her business stuff. So yeah, it was, has this been like a massive shift in the business world?
So what I really see hustle as, and what I saw, it wasn't actually the work that I was doing. It wasn't the amount of work I was doing. I probably do a lot more work as such because I have more clients now, I have more programs, but I've expanded time. And that's come directly through inner work. If you're in hustle mode, generally you're operating from a space of proving, not feeling good enough, having very leaky boundaries, low self-worth, imposter syndrome, underlying anxiety. I realized when I burned out that it was, you know, I had anxiety from childhood trauma. I was pulling out my hair when I was studying at like 10 years old. So, you know, it was something that was underlying, and I actually didn't even know what kind of feeling inner peace was. So when I see somebody hustling, it's an inner experience. It's also a disconnection from spirit. If you had trauma or abuse or something like that in your childhood, we disconnect from spirit. So we end up operating all from head, and we really just like drop, you know, we don't have any heart center, the sacral center is off, like all of those energy centers, your root chakra is like in in a space of like distress because it's just been all head. And none of the human designs are meant to be operating from a space of making decisions from their head. It's so that paradigm is something we're breaking now. That whole belief system is what we're breaking now. And that's how we're brought up as a society of like, you know, work harder. It takes a lot of work to make money. And it's not really about like when you're doing things in alignment, when you're creating. I mean, I've got three programs, I've got different digital courses, I've got a team. Obviously, I've got a life, a kind of a life. Well, I do have a life. I have an incredible life, in fact. And it's because my mindset now of like drama, I don't create drama. How many times are you hustling from a space of like, I need to get this, the ego is telling you, you know, if I don't hit those launch goals, then, you know, so-and-so is going to say something about me, or you're doing it for the wrong reasons. You're launching, selling just to make the money to kind of tell dad or mom or whoever that I've made the money. And that's really missing the whole fucking point of this, the whole point, you know, like how is that going to be sustainable? So that's how I always, when somebody's in this like hustle, have to do things, this proving, I always look at worthiness, boundaries, self-worth, what you're telling yourself about your work. And also, obviously, I spend a lot of time with my clients going through the unique gifts. We all uniquely gifted. We all have a destiny and we all have a purpose. And when we understand and align with that, it's beautiful. It's really beautiful, but we're told, you know, don't do what lights you up. Don't do what excites you. That's selfish. And that's really my work in the world, to break down those paradigms, those old paradigms, those facades, and really align with your soul. Your soul already guides you and knows, and your soul doesn't need to hustle. your soul already has all of the inner guidance. So we just need to spiritually align. We need to really connect. And that's why I love breathwork, is that it connects you. If you've been in your head for a very long time, it really connects you back to spirit to get that guidance. Does that answer your question? There's so many kind of levels to it.
There is. It's like doing the work before the work. And I, I do similar work to you. But the funny thing about it is people come to me and they go, but I just want to get to the 10K, Victoria. So how are you going to show that? And I say, hey, I've got all these different like things that you have to go through, releasing your blocks. That's what my program's called. But I just want the structure and strategy to get to the 10K. And I go, but that's not going to get you to the 10K. The structure and the strategy is not going to get you to the 10K or the 20 or the 30 or the 40 or the 50. It's not going to do it. So what I love about watching you as you work is that you are literally laying it out, saying, hey, you guys, you want these high levels. You can get to the 10K or the 20, but how are you going to maintain that? How are you going to do that? So it's like doing the work before the work. I love it.
Yeah. And I think that is something that's so big in the online space, is that people have these big six-figure launches. And then what happens next? And that's my, I had like a six-figure week. And that kind of like burnout happened very soon after that. The next month, I had like $7,000. I crashed because I couldn't actually maintain. Well, I mean, I did maintain the relationships, but just kind of, I wasn't able to take on more after that. And I had very kind of terrible boundaries. I was on all the time, taking loads of responsibility. And I think that's also a big conversation. We think that we need to fix people, or people need to be saved, or we need to take responsibility for other people. And that really kind of just takes that energy away from them. It takes that power away from your clients, and it drains you. When you say, you speak to their magnificence, speak to how brilliant everybody on this planet is. It doesn't matter where they are. They're all divine, incredible beings that have a higher purpose, a higher self, and really seeing somebody for their power. And I think that's something that I love, seeing their bigger vision and being like, of course, you can create it. Mm. You can do anything. If you can see it in your mind, you can create it in your reality. And in fact, it's already done in the quantum. That version of you that you're seeing in your mind is already done. So it's just about aligning the inner work, any subconscious belief patterns, releasing any energy blocks, and then creating that aligned intuitive strategy that really gets you.
You make it sound so easy, Vanessa. I love it. But the thing is, you make it sound easy, but you actually make it easy. And you actually said to me when we were messaging, you go, you know, if you get your messaging right, if you get your alignment with your design right, and I'm going to ask you a question about design in a minute, because I know some people don't know what I'm talking about, what we're talking about. But the thing is, you said, if you get your alignment right, your messaging and your strategy is as easy as brushing your teeth. And I'm not reading that from anywhere. It just stuck in my mind because I was like, and you did a little emoji of a tooth. And I was like, oh my God, that just is so funny. Because you're just saying, hey, life is fun, guys. Whether it's a six-figure launch and you do it 1 month, or whether you have a six-figure year, or whether you're hitting these 10Ks, or wherever you are, there's no levels of anyone being better than anybody else. It's about what it is that you truly desire, what it is that you are after, and how you're going to do that with your genius. So that's what I love about you, is you see the magic in other people. So with this aligning to your design, this is a little bit new to me, as you know. So I think you'd said, oh, Victoria, like you're here, there, and all over the place, which is amazing. So, you know, you could fit into this category, that category. And what happened? Oh, I did the test and I was nothing like I thought I was, or I had been portraying to be. In fact, I was the complete opposite. So human design is, a lot of people might see it like star signs, but it's not. It's kind of similar. So can you just explain to us what it is? We don't have to go through all the different types. People can reach out and all that type of stuff afterwards. But what is actually human design?
Yeah, amazing. So it's really the science of the aura. It uses astrology, astronomy, I Ching, chakras, to really kind of understand how you as a being operate with the world around you and the energy around you. So it's such an important thing to be able to align your energy. You're a projector, and you don't have this kind of internal energy. So your work and the way that you operate in the world is very much kind of seeing things from a bigger picture, staying in your energy, not working as much, not like doing loads of calls, loads of things, but really getting amazing at what you do in terms of studying and learning. And I think it's such a powerful kind of way of looking at it. I'm an MG, so I just kind of do everything and create everything. And if it makes sense to me, it makes sense to others. So I'm not great with like an ideal client. I've got 10 different kind of things open on my screen. So just to give you an idea, those listening, of kind of the different designs. And a lot of the time, most of us are kind of brought up to operate in a space of manifestors, which is kind of make it happen. You see the Nike ads, just do it. 8% of the population are manifestors. They're not the majority of your population. So really understanding how you're operating. It also, in your chart, you have your purpose. You have, you know, what you're meant to do. I'm meant to have a lot of fun. I'm meant to be a visionary. I'm meant to show the other designs that life is meant to be fun. And I'm meant to help others with financial freedom and self-love, which is all things that I'm incredibly passionate about. So that's all written already in your design, and it's created. There is part of your chart is from, you know, when the soul enters the space. So 90 days before it enters the mom's body. It's amazing. It is really amazing. So a lot of it is kind of unlearning and deconditioning. So it kind of gives you that amazing space of really connecting in with your soul to what resonates with you, because it is a human design experiment. There's no absolutes, but what your soul resonates with in that reading is going to be on some level your truth that maybe you've hidden. It's very great, I say, for the shadow side is really looking at your shadow side and owning those parts of you that maybe you've disowned. But also owning your purpose, and that, you know, it's written, it's already written. And that's why I say to you, it is as easy as that. We kind of create a lot of drama around everything. We are told that it's meant to be hard and building a business is hard. And we have that mindset. And of course, if you're brought up to believe it's hard, you're going to have that dialogue, your whole body, your whole way of being, what your reticular activating system sees online and in your world is all going to demonstrate hard. So flow and ease, it's not some like woo thing. It's actually a choice, and we can program our mind to start seeing and deciding and choosing that it gets to be easy. This is not to bypass the discomfort of change. That is another level, and that is another conversation, or we can speak about it if you desire, but that doesn't bypass that discomfort and growth that comes with up leveling. But I always think discomfort is so amazing. It's like, you know, get comfortable with the uncomfortable. If you are feeling discomfort, if you're, you know, shifting into a new space or new level, you know, celebrate it. Celebrate that your body is changing and shifting. And although you may feel some anxiety or, you know, sweaty palms or old trauma maybe rising to the surface as you shift into a new space of being, how incredible is that? That we're shedding this old identity, that we're shifting into a new space. So human design really supports me and supports my clients in understanding their purpose, how their energy works, how we're meant to respond to the world around us. And then it really indicates where you're out of alignment and there is, you know, deconditioning and learning that needs to happen to really peel back the onion layers and get you back into alignment. So it's a powerful tool, and then used with the kind of the marketing strategy for the different designs, it's beautiful. It really is an exciting space. And when you are energized, when you are in a space of fun, pleasure, joy, how does it feel in your business? How do you feel?
And well, that's the thing with me, ever since I've been aligning, since I figured out my human design. And, you know, I kind of steered away from it for a little while because I was like, okay, you know, I've got all these different things. And, you know, because I was following Vanessa myself, I was like, she keeps talking about human design, and I'm just going to, I've got to guess that I'm this one. And I was like, oh, I'm actually a Virgo. So I'm not very good at wanting to just guess. I actually do want my facts as well. So I was like, oh, fine, I'll just do the test, because there's a free test that you can do, right? And then when I reached out to Vanessa, I was like, oh my God, what? No, this can't be right. She was like, okay, Victoria, it's okay. You've just been functioning a different way. And like, what I want to say to the listeners as well is it's very comprehensive. Like, it's very, there's so many layers to it, but it's just like a star sign. You might know what you are and you might know a couple of your traits, or you might go so deep into it that you're like, this is fascinating. I want to know everything there is. And so I had a reading, and I think it's absolutely amazing. And as I've been aligning, I don't get anxiety anymore. I don't get that whole, oh my gosh, like, and if I do, I'm just like, it's just not happening. I need to go rest. I'm going to the beach. I've canceled clients, and that's not ideal, but I've canceled them. I've said, look, I really desire to give you the best possible session. And right now, because I do mediumship and all that type of stuff, so I'm like, right now, I'm a little bit energetically drained, so I will catch up with you later. So it's getting to know your, nearly like your boundaries within your design, like if that's how you explain it. I don't really know how to explain it, but you can go as deep as you like, really. You could study this stuff for a whole entire year, or
yeah,
just go as deep as you like, really.
Even understanding the five different types, the projector, the reflector, the manifesting generator, and generator, actually just understanding that high level is incredible to shift you, and then understanding the gates and your not self. I think your not self theme is important as well. Because when you, so mine is frustration. So whenever I'm feeling in a space of frustration, I know that that's really my indication that I'm out of alignment, and just coming back to my truth in terms of what is not aligned, or how can you realign? And that, I mean, the universe responds to alignment, not time as well. And this is what we have to remember, is it's not about like how much can we do in a space of time, or, you know, how much can we hustle if we're exhausted. It's really about like how aligned are we in this space? How good do we feel? And when we understand energy, everything is energy. So everything you're putting out there, you know, if you put out a piece of content and you really believe in what you're maybe selling at the end, and you're excited about selling it, there is that different energy, and it will convert. Whereas if you put something out and it's like, oh, I don't really like that program, I don't really like what I'm selling, I don't really believe in it, I don't believe in the transformations, you'll notice that it won't convert. It can have exactly the same copy. I've seen that with clients, exact same copy. I've even done it myself, is like repurpose some content because it worked really well at one point. And it just doesn't get that same response. It's that energy that we need to bring to it. So the most important thing is not the strategy. It's not all the shoulds and the have tos. Yes, everything is a strategy. Everything we create has some sort of strategy, even if it's our loose strategy in the way that we desire to create it. And it needs to make sense to us, to our energy. It needs to excite us on some level. So yeah, I think it's an incredible tool to use, an incredible reading to have, and then to build your business in alignment with that, and obviously your life and your relationships, and even the way you eat and things like that they're in your human design. So it's beautiful.
It's amazing. And I think as well, like in relationships with human design, like my husband is a generator, and I've got a Mani Gen daughter and a generator son. And the first thing I did when my husband joined my business was I sat down and I said, look, we have to have a meeting. Now, I am a projector. This is the way I function. And I'm not doing this to put labels, but I do believe that like things don't define us, but having an understanding about like the non-self theme that you were saying before, mine is bitterness. So when I desire something more, then other people do, like my clients, if I want their business to thrive more than they do, or they're not showing up and doing the work, I really do get a little bit bitter. And then I'm like, oh my gosh, what am I doing? So I actually had the conversation with my husband. Look, when you're aligned, you might want to keep going. I'm not going to do it. So I actually say, good night, I'm going to bed. And he'll stay up until 11 o'clock at night working on our business. Now I know from learning this, I can't unlearn what I've just learned, which is this is the way I function now. I do not work more than 4 or 5 hours, like continuously ever, which is funny because I was a hairdresser for years and years and years, and I worked, you know, 10-hour sessions, all that type of stuff. So I think it's absolutely fascinating, and I highly recommend everybody find out what their human design is.
Yeah, but obviously you are feeling like, you know, I'm tired. There's not enough energy for me to create all of this. How are other people doing it? Or how is so-and-so kind of doing all these things and creating all these things and doing all these long hours? And at a soul level, you knew that there was something out of alignment. And that really, all that did was just confirm and give you permission essentially to say, you know, yeah, it's cool. You can chill out. You can do 3 to 4 hours max of work. And then something that you love doing is mastering your craft and learning and researching. And that's kind of the rest of your working time, essentially. And then having a lot of space in between calls to nap, giving yourself permission to nap. We kind of grow up, most of us grow up of like, you know, it's lazy to nap or stop sleeping on the job, you know, like all of those sort of things. It's just really that remembrance of who you know you are underneath all the layers. So it kind of, I suppose it speeds up that process of really understanding who you are at your core and what your soul is really saying to you, especially with a lot of people are disconnected from their intuition, disconnected from their soul. So it really kind of, when something resonates, you can't unsee it, but your soul already knows.
And you just go click, 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 click. Like, you think about it, right? Chronic fatigue, mental illness. Like, I mean, I know a lot about entities and mental illness, but that's definitely another conversation. But my client's going, oh my gosh, I've got chronic fatigue. Other people are like, I'm just exhausted. And I'm like, hey guys, let's just go check your human design. Projector. And I'm like, oh my God. Then I've got another client who's a mani-gen, and I'm like, okay, how am I going to coach her? Because she's here, there, and everywhere with these amazing, incredible ideas. And I want to nurture that. So it's made me a better coach. So any practitioners or coaches that are listening to this, I really do believe it makes you a better coach, because just like when you're learning the disc or whatever thing resonates with you, you know how to talk to those people. You cannot hold down, say, a mani-gen, but with a projector, you're like, go rest, darling.
Yeah. And the relationship that you have with your clients is slightly different as a projector to a manifesting generator, unless the manifesting generator is actually really asking you for advice, which they would be if they're hiring you. So giving a manifesting generator or a generator kind of off the cuff advice when their aura is not actually ready for it, they'll often say, no, that doesn't resonate, or whatever the case may be. And that's also what creates a lot of bitterness for projectors, because they see things differently. They see efficiencies, they see tweaks, whereas generators, manifesting generators, they're in the action all the time. They're in the mud, kind of doing all the things. And we need these projectors to see it. But if they're not ready, if their aura is not ready to kind of receive it. So I think it's such an incredible space, not only with clients, but obviously with, as you said, with your relationship and really just understanding and your team. That's something we're doing a lot of work around now, is understanding, you know, there isn't a bad team member to hire in terms of the human design, but it's understanding how that person operates, what lines them up, if they're a projector. Sean's, my fiance, is a projector, and he's the same. He's like, you know, 3 hours of work, and it's very great. Like, it's very detail orientated. It's very efficient, high attention to detail. But you know, don't ask him to do something at like 7 PM when I get my second wind. You know, like that's done, and understanding that that's not because, you know, he doesn't want to do it, or he's lazy, or whatever labels that we create for people. We actually, I mean, I think it's just such an incredible thing. Also the reflectors, you know, a lot of people create these judgments around, you know, people becoming like their partner or becoming like the friends that they're with. And actually the reflectors do that. They are the chameleons of the world. They literally become the person, and they can read them at a deep level. A lot of reflectors are psychics, and I mean, obviously we're all psychics, but they're deeply psychic. And I think it's an incredible thing to understand and recognize.
Wow, you've just like sold me on human design all over again. And I was already sold. That was amazing, amazing. Oh, so good, so good. So I just wanted, there's something else I want to touch on as well, which I love it. I did one of your 5-day challenges. I can't remember when, but I did something of yours and I was listening to it. And you talked about pussy power. And what I love about that, it all kind of ties in. The stuff that you talk about is all slightly different, but it's the same, because again, going from that masculine business coach that you were, I mean, it'd be hard to see you as masculine because you're so not, but you know what I mean? The energy of masculine and just the doing and the funnels and the this and the that and stuff like that, which is still really relevant, but without having that kind of pussy power. So can we just have a little chat about what that actually is? Because I know it's around everywhere. Everyone's talking about it. And why is it so important to embrace our feminine divine energy?
Yeah. And I think, you know, even we were having a conversation around like even saying pussy is really difficult sometimes, because we've been taught to not honor our pleasure, not honor that the clitoris has 8,000 beautiful nerve endings basically built for our pleasure and our turn on and our excitement. So it's really, when I speak about that, is it's like, yes, it's coming back to how much pleasure can you actually handle in your business? How turned on can you feel in your business? And then when you're from that space of turn on, pleasure, excitement, fun, what do you then create from that space? So the masculine is, as we said just now, it's very important, those strategies, those routines, those systems. But if we're doing them from a masculine, wounded masculine space, we're just creating hustle. Mm. And maybe that's a really great way of kind of looking at it. When you come in from the space of creativity and intuition and turn on and pleasure and fun and joy, and then you create your strategy from that, it's just magnetic, isn't it? It's kind of, you can't not be excited about being around somebody that is so excited and so engrossed and so passionate about what they do, and that this strategy is only an extension of their most expressed, connected, pleasurable self. So really that pussy reclamation is coming back to the divine feminine, and not the wounded feminine, which is kind of that weak, brittle, very like overly emotional. Emotions are an incredible thing. And I suppose that's another conversation as well that we could speak about, but, you know, feeling all of your emotions. We're so, you know, devoid of these are good emotions, those are bad emotions. And if you feel angry, sad, frustrated, any of that, like don't go there, don't show that. And we end up suppressing and creating this real, you know, this big thing, this shadow side. And what you see and what you tend to see online, and I often, you know, I liken it to a kiddie's playground, because, you know, I'm right. No, you're right. You know, it's like, this is my one thing. And it's like, we're operating not only from an emotional space that is not in alignment with our physical age, so much younger, our wounded feminine, which tends to happen a lot, that we're actually, and from that space, sex, sensuality, pleasure, clitoris, pussy, all of those words become a very, you know, difficult space to speak about. And you know how many conversations I have around sex and relationships with clients, because your sex and your money are interlinked. If you're not turned on and excited and pleasurably activated, you'll also repel money. And that's an amazing kind of link to start seeing in your sacral center with money, with pleasure. So basically, yes, the more turn on, the more fun you have, the more pleasure you have, the more money you make. Mm. And that's not just kind of a random mantra. It really is the truth. When you heal from that space, when you heal that sacral center, when you get more in alignment, when you get more turned on, more excited, you obviously put that out into the world. And that sexual energy is very magnetic. It's, you know, it's very magnetic. And that's where we, when we operate from that life force energy, your pussy is life force giving. It's where all life comes from.
Literally.
So it is. Literally. Exactly. So yeah, it's such a powerful kind of way of growing your business, expanding your business, expanding your energy. And one of the biggest things I always ask myself and my clients is like, well, okay, that's pleasurable, but let's turn that up. So how much pleasure can you handle? Mm-hmm. Or how much more pleasure can you create in all areas of your life? And that's not just your business. Okay, let's start with the business. Let's think about the way you dress and kind of, you know, what turns you on about what you wear, what you eat. You know, we shovel down food rather than spending time in pleasure. So that's my shortened version of something that I'm clearly quite passionate about. I'm just responding.
It's really about making life one big orgasm, really. Like, yeah, everything should be orgasmic. And what you were saying before about, you know, we're talking about hustle and work and is this life meant to be hard? How can life be hard when you're having fun? Like, do you really think that when kids are playing out, like my son playing out in the dirt pile, or my daughter playing with her Barbies or whatever she does, like all the fun mm-hmm. things she does, she's working hard, right? But is that really hard? No, it's not, because it's pure joy. So when I'm doing readings and when you're doing coaching, and sure, sometimes I go, okay, my energy, I require to go rest. But when I'm aligned with myself and when my body is turned on and so excited about an offer, then you can't stop me. It's really about being obsessed with your job, because you are so aligned with your unique gift that nothing will stop you. And I work with a lot of people who have their bodies turned off, and I talk about sex a lot. And it was one thing being brought up Catholic that I did not talk about with my mother, with my friends. All I knew about it was if you sleep with too many people, you were basically a slut. And, you just wasn't, like, you just weren't allowed to enjoy it. So it was like a dirty little secret, you know? And so how much of us are seeing sex as dirty, or being mm-hmm. turned on as dirty, or we're seeing the stuff that happens in the world and we are resisting and reacting to that and saying, no, I want no part of this. So we're turning off our body, including that sacral center that you're talking about, which is our creativity, everything. So how can you create or earn money or have great relationships, or sex for that matter, if you're shutting mm-hmm. everything down? Mm-hmm. You know, so, and I think being turned on is like from your fingertips to your toes. So your everything has to be turned on. Like, it's, you know, children very much have that energy as well. They have that energy of sex, not because they're having actual sex, but they have this life force, exactly what you said. It's life force running through you, which is what sex is. But we shut that down. And this is where a lot of your work comes in, and a lot of my stuff as well, with the subconscious beliefs, because what is happening is down that line, that generational line that's come down, where, you know, three generations ago, it was very much sex was for procreation. You probably got married to someone because, not because you love them, because of your line that you were in, or whatever. So it all kind of comes down now through our DNA and all these different things. So I think, talking about pussy power, even though I'm still getting my mouth around that word, in all honesty, it's just so essential. Like, I can say sex very easily, but, you know, how much strength is within women? What's your group called? The Visionary Entrepreneurs, you know, for women stepping up into their genius, into their grace and their joy and their orgasmic self. Like, it's just so exciting.
It is exciting. And you can even feel like when you get into that space of knowing that that's available for you, I think that's the biggest thing. I mean, even if we can't say a pussy, which is like a part of us, it's, you know, a very essential part. And that obviously also links to kind of menstruation and all those sort of things that we also don't want to speak about in society. And that's also one of the things that I've also started incorporating into my work is like your cycles, your menstrual cycles, and how your energy does naturally fluctuate and shift throughout that cycle. And we go through that rebirth and that death every 28 days. And we're shedding and we're releasing. So we're naturally growing unless we're fighting it, which most of us probably have done, or we have some, you know, weird sort of, well, not weird, but well, it is weird. Yeah. Weird kind of mindset around it, that it's dirty, or, you know, it's not a natural process to menstruate, which is so, you know, it's so scary. It's so scary to think that a natural process that we have every single month for a lot of years of our lives is something that we reject or we think is dirty or disgusting. And it's not. It's actually a very beautiful, beautiful thing. But also there is a lot of, when you understand maybe your first menstruation as well, you can also understand the viewpoint of the feminine as well, of how you view the feminine, how you view yourself, how you view operating from the feminine. So it's also another just a fascinating, fascinating topic.
And it's one of those things that we have been shut down with about the menstrual cycle, about how, you know, there's no rest for the wicked. You know, like that saying, it's like, you must keep on going. But back in the day in the tribes, they used to celebrate these women. These women were the visionaries, which is so funny because I was just talking about your group being a visionary. And you were there to, you know, sit there and download what was coming in the villages. You were there to sit there and rest, and everybody loved you and adored you. And then as we went down these generations, I remember my great-grandmother saying that when the rags were on the line, that they would, that all the boys would laugh, point and laugh, point and laugh. And it's like, well, no wonder you don't talk about it. You just pretend it's not happening like you do with lots of other areas in your life as well. So I think, you know, for our viewers as well, it's a really good point to, when we're opening ourselves up to more consciousness, because what you essentially do is conscious business, really. Yeah. When we're doing conscious business, conscious life, because let's face it, it's not just in one area. Like Vanessa was a brilliant, brilliant businesswoman, but obviously, you know, you shifted and changed because you desired more and you brought abundance into every area of your life. And I think it's really good to remember, or maybe relevant to remember, that our cycles and the moon cycles and all of these other things can really make a difference as we're becoming more conscious.
Yeah, we can't, when we become conscious, we are more conscious of how we feel. We're more conscious of how we're thinking, how we're acting. And if we keep going, you know, I'm tired, this is pathetic, like, and it might be kind of, just before your cycle, in your cycle, maybe you will need some more rest. Maybe you will need to eat a little bit more. And starting to really, this connection back to your body, that is such a huge part. And then if you can connect head to body or mind to body, and then connect with your spirit and your soul, you can feel that alignment. You can feel that truth. I always say, you know, you're a messenger, you're a vessel, you're guided and protected on this journey. And essentially there's nothing to worry about in this space if you're honoring yourself, if you're listening into your intuition. And we're so addicted in society to busyness. Who's filling their schedule the most? Who's doing the most? Who's creating the most? And there is this like underlying competition of like who's the busiest. And the reality is most people stay so busy and so disconnected to actually avoid their truth, avoid what is meant to come through here. And there's this distrust of like, what is the message that I'm going to receive? And I suppose that's why there's so many people still in the spiritual closet. There's so many people disconnected from spirit. And that's obviously your zone of genius and something that you love speaking about. But, you know, going back to kind of that hustle, yes, if you are disconnected from your body, disconnected from spirit, and you're all mind, that's where that hustle really lives. And when you're in divine flow, there is really that kind of deep trust, faith, connection. And it doesn't mean that life is all unicorns and rainbows. Mine certainly is not. But I just get better at that emotional intelligence and better at when something happens, what maybe used to take me, you know, weeks probably to recover from. It may take minutes or it may take an hour or something like that. So really being mindful of that connection, and then being mindful of where you're operating from, your wounded self and your wounded trauma. And as you become more and more conscious, obviously, yeah, your shadow self is an important gift for your people, for your expansion, for your truth. Yeah, it's a really exciting topic. I think we could go on all day. There's so much, so many incredible things to...
So I just want to basically finish off really with saying, you know, if people are at the beginning of this journey, because I love what you just said about, you know, you get through it, your emotional awareness, your emotional maturity, whatever you mastery, emotional mastery, I teach that, I'll just use that word. Basically with that, you can get through it in an hour or a day rather than a week or a month or a year. Now, this is very relevant for me because it used to take me, you know, a week or three to get over an event of something, if something annoyed me. But now I literally ask myself questions. This is where we come in as coaches. We can work through it really fast. And my last coach said to me, I can no longer work with you because you've got emotional mastery. You can work through anything yourself. Doesn't mean I won't hit emotions. It just means I'm more practiced at working through all the different stages. So, you know, I want everybody to really acknowledge that, you know, both Vanessa and myself, we have things constantly come up, but we also love growth and expansion, which means we step into the creative chaos of change to go, oh, what could this look like, and get really curious about it. So Vanessa, just to finish off on, for those women who desire to do more, they desire to show up online and they feel like, you know, they've got all these things against them. So basically it's just too hard because it's all saturated. The internet is saturated. We've just had COVID. So of course it's too hard. They've got this divine burning desire to do more. What is just like three little tips you would say to them?
Yeah, I think the biggest thing is understanding where it's coming from. So what is it that's driving that thought? So, you know, if it's not COVID, it's probably been something else that you've kind of used it as an excuse and a reason to avoid your truth. So really understanding, like, where is it coming from? What is that fear that is driving your behavior? What is that subconscious belief pattern? And this is obviously something that's really important for you to work through with somebody. But understanding where that fear is, understanding what the story you're telling yourself is, and also, you know, to be honest, cutting the bullshit, because if it was COVID, or, you know, if it was, you know, a family member telling you something or judgment, like, there's always going to be something external. And remembering, that's the second point, is that nothing external to you really impacts your internal world. It's getting your internal world really resilient and powerful through, obviously, understanding your patterns, understanding the conditioning. And the third thing is knowing that it is going to be uncomfortable. There is going to be discomfort, and maybe old trauma is going to come to the surface that you've maybe sorted out and you've dealt with. You're never done. You're never completely done. If you were completely done and completely there, then you wouldn't be on this planet. But it's understanding that you're not broken, that you don't need fixing, that there isn't something deficient about you. It's that there needs to be a propensity for discomfort and leaning into that discomfort. And I think I said it at the beginning, that discomfort is growth. So yes, there may be discomfort. Maybe your brain's telling you can't do it. Maybe there's, you know, the amygdala in your brain is kind of really flooded with cortisol and you're in a stressed out space. One of the things that I always say to myself is, like, something old comes up, it's like, okay, that's old stuff. We've released that. We've gone through it. Life is allowed to get better and better. And I always say to myself, is like, hell yeah. You know, this feeling that I'm getting now, we're just going to lean into it. We're going to take the aligned action and we're going to take the messy action, because what typically tends to happen, and the reality is if you don't do it in this lifetime, you're going to have to come back and do it again. So you might as well lean into it, into that discomfort. And that's celebrating that means that you're shifting. You know, there's billions of different chemical reactions that are happening in the brain and the body all the time. And that's why we get into that space of being addicted to a certain story and pattern, and we keep in the cycle. And breaking that, or breaking the habit of being ourselves, is going to take discomfort. It is going to take a little bit of a space of, and obviously this becomes less so as you move through things, and obviously meditation and different tools and working with somebody is an incredible space, and having that accountability as well is so important when you're moving through to another level of income or impact or starting something new. So the online space is not saturated. If you're using your unique gifts, your unique skills, your unique knowledge, and sharing your story and not being afraid that, you know, the shitty things that have happened are actually a really powerful part of healing the collective. And yes, it may feel like everybody in your aunt is online, but how many people are still unconscious? How many people are still struggling? How many people need your support? And if you're called to this work, you're meant to do it. You're meant to, you know, you're meant to put it out there in the world. So cutting the BS around the stories that you've got, getting the support that you need, and knowing that it is going to be uncomfortable. It's something totally different, and that there may be anxiety, there may be old stuff coming up for you, and that it's okay. If you keep retreating, keep running back to the old version of you, you're just going to have to face it again and again and again. So that's something I also love seeing is, you know, and breaking is we see these patterns, the survival mode pattern that just happens and it keeps looping and looping and looping. And it's very difficult to see that ourselves because it's all automatic. We've been firing and wiring. If we had trauma at 4 or 3 or whatever in our unconscious space, we've been living in that circle and that cycle for, you know, a good amount of years. So to break it, of course, is going to take a little bit of discomfort. And I think, as a nation, we're all like, no pain, no gain kind of situation. It's different because it's not meant to hurt you or affect you. It's actually going to be amazing. But the brain likes the familiar, and it likes that familiar pattern. So actually understanding and looking at the, making that next level familiar for you, making it more beneficial.
Yeah, exactly. There's so much. No, I love it. That was perfect. Perfect, because, you know, we have to grow, we have to step into it. And I've got to say, that's one thing I am fairly good at, is stepping into uncomfortable things. Even if I'm shaking, I don't care. If I shake, if I freak out, I'm like, if I know that something is aligned and it's my soul's purpose, I knew I was going to be doing mediumship before I was even a so-called medium. And then I just trusted, and all of it, I can read really, really well. I can talk to spirits, dead people, and it's kind of crazy. But at the same time, I know that is my unique gift. So I think everybody has a unique gift. And if you are only willing to show up and do all of those things that Vanessa just said, which was perfect, then you would actually find that you, if you meet the universe halfway, then you're going to receive so much more, so much more.
And life gets beautiful. And life gets better and better. And how good can you actually let it get? Because what's driving 95% of what's happening right now in your life is subconscious belief patterns based on old paradigms, old things, and mostly a disconnection from your soul, your spirit, and your body. And as you say, you kind of get people back into alignment, get their body, like their energy centers back, and connect them back to spirit and really read them in that way. It's just, it's really, I think it's really the new age business building from a conscious visionary perspective. It's like we've lived in this paradigm of head strategy because, yeah, we think that there's this magic strategy, this 1-2-3-step process that's going to save our business. And I think that's really the difficult part to get your head around, is that there isn't one strategy. There isn't one size fits all. And you actually are the strategy as the energy body that you are. And it doesn't matter if you have the fanciest funnel, the most incredible Facebook ads, if your energy is not in it, you'll sabotage. And I think really working on all of those elements is such an important part.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Vanessa. How can we find you? I know you've got free group, you've got all sorts of things. It will be in the show notes for you guys as well, so you can find Vanessa. I've really got to recognize that Vanessa does a lot of amazing contributions for the world within free stuff as well. So a lot of the content I have received from Vanessa has been free, which has been phenomenal. And then of course you can just imagine her paid stuff is just next level. So whereabouts can we find you? So if these guys are really wanting to get more of you.
Yeah. And I think that's also an important thing in terms of giving value to your community. We are here to give value and to shift people and to create a change. And then, as you say, like you did Unleash Yourself, I think, a while ago. So to find me, I am on Instagram for kind of the behind the scenes stuff. I'm at Vanessa Business Coach. I'm also, my Visionary Entrepreneur Society is probably one of my favorite spaces to hang out and connect. And that's where a lot of the free trainings are. So those are probably my websites, vanessahalleck.com. But I think those are the two biggest spaces to be, is my Instagram and in my group, Feels Aligned.
Beautiful. So awesome. I hope you guys have enjoyed this as much as I have. It's been an absolute pleasure to have you giving so much free content. Absolutely amazing. And you guys keep an eye out, because this beautiful Manny Jen has always got something brewing up, or creating, I should say. And like Vanessa said, we can really feel, you know, what is aligned, and you can feel it in somebody's text, in their message, if they are aligned or not, you know, just like reading a text. So it's, and yours is always aligned, Vanessa, always, every time it just like pops out at you. So fabulous. Thank you so much. I've enjoyed you immensely. I'm sure everybody else has as well. You guys, make sure you leave some comments and let us know what your favorite pick was from this. Take, not pick. And we'd love to know what was your aha moments with all of this amazingness. So thank you so much, Vanessa, and we're looking forward to seeing what you create next.
Guys, thank you so much for having me, and just, yeah, I hope for everybody listening that there was some takeaways and something that shifted. That's always an important part of my work when I'm doing anything, is my belief that even this free content and podcasts and anything that we create, it does shift people on some level to create a bit of change. Thank you so much.
Thank you. I'll see you guys later. Thank you so much, Vanessa. See ya. Bye. And that's a wrap for today. Thank you so much for joining the Release Your Blocks podcast. If you enjoyed this episode, I would love to hear from you. So please leave a review and tell me what your favorite takeaway from today was. There is so much more from where this came from. You can also find me at Holistic Energy Shifting on Facebook, where you can find more content, more coaching, and more guidance. Have a grand and glorious day, and I'll see you next time.